beautiful Punahou campus here in Honolulu, Hawaii, for tonight's Clash of the Titans. I'm Chris Schwengel, he's my partner, Peter Bald, and we got quite the matchup tonight, don't we, Peter?
Yeah, we do, Chris. Both teams had great matches last night. It was real competitive. Punahou came out on top of their tight match with MiraCosta, and Santa Barbara had a kind of a hard-fought match. Games 3 and 4 were real tight with Kamehameha from the Big Island. So should be pretty exciting here.
It's a true match of the Titans in the volleyball world, isn't it?
Yes, it is. You know, historically, Santa Barbara is kind of the top team in their area, which is obviously up in the Santa Barbara area of California, Southern California, and Punahou consistently is the top, one of the top teams in the state of Hawaii. So it's a great opportunity.
Difficult to talk about high school volleyball without mentioning these two programs.
Very much so. You know, there's a lot of history in, on both sides of athletes that have kind of, you know, gone through the halls and played in the gym, that have gone on to further collegiate and international success from both of these schools. So it should be an exciting match. As everybody's kind of, you know, there are some health issues with both teams, but I think that you definitely will see some good volleyball tonight.
Right. We know Santa Barbara bench runs deep, just like the Punahou bench runs pretty deep. So despite some injuries, we're in for some great volleyball, I think.
Yeah, and I talked to the coach, Chad Arneson, that, you know, he's had to kind of shuffle his squad from the very first match in terms of injuries and sickness. And Punahou's been kind of the same with some of their injuries along the way. So,
And you have a lot of coaching experience. There's never in your many years been a season where there is non-injuries.
You know, it's rare.
Right.
It really is rare. I mean, there's just too much that can go on with sickness and ankles and shoulders and backs these days. Kids are playing a lot more volleyball indoors with the club scene and stuff, and so there's a lot more opportunity for overuse injuries and whatnot.
Yep, so that wear and tear on these young bodies, right?
Yep.
All right, we're going to kick off some announcements here for the PA announcer, Mike Machado, and we're going to be echoing his announcement.
Volleyball fans, and welcome to Everett Field House on the campus of Punahou School for Day 2 of play in the Clash of the Titans on the volleyball tournament. At this time, we ask that you please rise for the singing of our national anthem.
And we're going to sing our national anthem here in Honolulu. Singing tonight is Punahou School Junior, Na'ima Moore. Those of you at home, please stand and take off your hats.
Twilight's at whose frost and birds fall.
lovely rendition by Naima Moore, Punahou School Junior.
You know, I'm always amazed at how people are able to sing that song so well.
Even in a crowd of a few hundred or a few thousand, I would not be able to do that. So let's get going with some introductions from the volleyball teams here. We got the Santa Barbara Dons and the Punahou Buff and Blue. We're going to meet the starting lineup for the Dons. 6 foot senior, number four, Joe Rafferty.
6, Carl
senior Carl Mendoza. Number seven, Ryan Worley. Quinn Dickinson. And senior Channing Peak. And Will Poliche.
And
rounded out for the Dons.
Hark
Pritchard setting for the Dons. Head coach Chad Arneson. And now the Punahou Buff and Blue. Scott Colin Peros. Capono Fay. Daniel Andrews, number 10 for the Buff and Blue.
Noah
Hayashida. Taylor Weens. Setting for the Buff and Blue, Micah Ma'a. And Tui Leta for the Buff and Blue. Coached by Rick Toon. And let's get going with some volleyball. What do you say, Peter? What's one thing you notice when I look at the two teams? I like to watch them match up, shake hands before the match. That's always nice to see.
Well, you know, I know.
Size-wise, we notice something, though, don't we?
Yeah, I think the Punahou, they're pretty similar in size here. I think that, the kids that are actually going to be on the court are pretty well balanced. You know,
right.
Punahou's got a couple of kids that are real tall. One of them doesn't play a whole lot. The other one starts at the middle, and Danny Andrews, so.
It looks to me like the Buff and Blue look a little smaller than usual this year.
You know, they do, and I'm not sure why that is, but, those kinds of things have an ebb and flow to them.
Right.
Santa Barbara started a couple of their bigger guys last night, and tonight they're going with a little smaller lineup. So.
We don't call them short. We call them closer to the ground, right? But I do notice, some big shoulders over there for the Dons. They look like they've haven't skipped too many meals recently. And I was down on the floor earlier, and I'm standing at about 6 foot 2 inches, and I was looking up at most of them.
Yeah, they come in with pretty good size, and last night they did well. They've got a nice nice libero. He plays well. As a matter of fact, his sister is a student at the UH and kind of a beach player and plays well for them. So.
I'm sorry, there's a correction from the booth. They're saying that I'm 6 foot 3 inches. I lean towards humility.
You know, volleyball players are always padding their stats, so.
All right, let's get started. It's a beautiful day here in Honolulu. We got blue skies, and we got a buzz in the air because it is prom night, and I'm sure you'll hear me making plenty of references to nerves, probably due to the Buff and Blue players having their mind on prom. Here we go, serve for the Dons. Peros to Ma'a in the middle. Handled well by the Dons. Throw dink. It's a good first start.
You know, it was a good start. But the coach ironically told me, the one thing they don't want to do is to serve the libero, Scotty Peros. And
right off the bat, he
got the first pass. And
Ma'a back to serve for the Buff and Blue. Handled well. Setter comes out a little far. Back set.
You know, interesting there, the Punahou called down on that. The set was wide of the antenna, and you don't always see that. I like the fact that they did call down and let the guy have a go, and actually he was the one who made the mistake.
Set to Quinlan. Puts it down, but out.
Okay, so early on here, you got a couple of hitting errors. I mean, they've given Punahou two free points in that.
They got to pass a little bit further up for the setter. He's having to come out to that 10-foot line each time. Setter goes out again, puts it up pretty well, nicely. Ma'a to Peros, to the middle to Kaponofe, who draws them into the net.
Well, you know, I like that play early on. I think that Punahou's had kind of a rut, gotten in a rut in the last couple weeks of going to Tui all the time. And I like the fact that they're going to somebody to score, somebody other than him to score a point.
Short, quick set to the middle, handled well. Put back over by the Dons, joust at the net. Ma'a to set, sets Tui Leta on the outside. Let's see if we get a touch.
Ooh, I thought that ball was good.
I thought it was touched.
Well, at any rate, it was a nice rally, and it was a great play by Santa Barbara. Just kind of, you know.
Number seven, Ryan Worley, back to serve for the Dons. Nice floater, set to the middle, handled nicely in the middle there. Back set. The setter is not afraid to go out to the 10-foot line and still do a back set, though.
You know, I noticed that last night, too. I think he's a real good setter. Goes to guys that he likes to. He challenges himself. He goes against the flow a little bit.
Good serve. Putting Kaponofe on his butt right away. And blocked. That all started with a great serve.
It was really a good serve. Forced Kaponofe to have to pass the ball and kind of took him out of the offense as a back row attacker and made it kind of one-dimensional because it wasn't really that good of a pass, and so he had to flick it all the way back to Tui.
Worley back to serve for the Dons. We've got 4-3, buff and blue. Going to serve a jump floater again. Barros with his hand set. Out ball.
Yeah, but I like that choice. Yeah. You know, I think early on, you know, he's one-on-one. He had the open court. He kind of overran the play a little bit.
You got to mix it up. Got to establish it. A variety of options for the setter. That's good. Pass that spike.
You know, I like that Micah is going as Taylor Weens on that, and I like the fact that Micah's trying to get him involved in the offense early in the match here. I think that bodes well for later in the game when they want to go to Tui and Kaponofe.
Tui back to serve, handled well at the net, outside. Nice play, Dons.
Great hit by them.
That's number nine, Quinn Dickinson, and he's coming back to serve.
You know, he was a sub last night. And so it's a great opportunity for him to get a start here today and see what he can do.
A little floater to Tui in the middle. Out to, chest pass. Good dump by the set. Ma'a out to Faye. Good block by the Dons. Let's see what happened. Net violation, Dons. Kaponofe hits a heavy ball, doesn't he?
He does. And you know what? I like that play because, you know, it was a high ball. Santa Barbara knew that they were going out to him, and he swung high for the block and got a nice, you know, chance for the team to keep playing again.
And we got another net call on the Dons here. Kaponofe will be at UH next year, is that right?
Yes, he will. He will.
And he probably has a few more inches to grow, it looks like.
You know, I think so. He's a big kid, and his parents are both pretty good size.
Back set. Number seven, Ryan Worley, who puts it in the net for the Dons.
You know what Hart Pritchard does real well that I like is he sets against the flow. You'll see him move forward, and then he'll jack that ball, you know, to the opposite, you know, on the backside.
It's confidence and skill to go downstream like that. And Ma'a's going to kick himself for not digging that up. I think he just wasn't ready. With Toon giving him an eyeball there.
I think he knows. They kind of look a little bit like they feel like they should be taking a nap.
Yes.
You know, at 3 o'clock on a Saturday afternoon instead of playing a game. So
practicing dance moves all morning, no doubt. They've got to go get their hair did after this match. Serve back to Tui Leta, hand pass. Out to Faye. Again with that heavy ball, unable to handle it.
You know, I tell you what, if Santa Barbara is going to, you know, make any moves here on Punahou, they're going to have to, one, put a little bit more pace on the ball. And they can't put they need to serve a little bit more to the sidelines. Yeah. They're putting it right in the middle of the court where the Punahou doesn't have to, you know, do a whole lot to make a good
number
pass.
Six back to
Dylan Girard.
Dylan Girard for the buff and blue puts it into the net.
You know, it looked like it was a new serve for him. I don't recall him serving a jump spike serve. His normal go-to is a jump float. So,
Hart Pitcher back to serve for the Dons. Jump. Spinner, Out to Perros, bringing the setter out a little bit. Ma'a taking a swing at it.
You know, Puno's been, they've been going with this a little bit, running the 6-2 when Micah gets to the front. And, you know, I'm not certain that I entirely like it. It's worked well at certain moments, but...
They can throw a defense off, that's for sure, when the setter starts swinging, right? A little
pancake.
Instead of spiking, he sets it over the net. Maybe that's the plan of attack for the Buff and Blue. Ma'a takes a good swing at it, handled easily by the Dons. Pitcher to the middle, out ball.
Yeah, you know, there's all kinds of schools of thought. You know, it gives you three attackers in the front the whole time. The thing I don't like is you've got two different release points, right, and speeds of the offense with two different setters, and I'm not a real big fan of it.
Faye with a good float, line floater, up the spike. Gerard, again, wanting that dig.
You know, they
knowing he should have had it.
Yeah, and it looks to me like, you know, Puno's got to get their block and move it out to the line. Santa Barbara seems to have, you know, scouted last night, and they keep peppering the line on that outside out there. So
number four, Joe Rafferty back to serve. Perros sends him way back. I love that serve right there in the middle to Daniel Andrews. He started with a great pass.
It was a great pass because, you know what, it was a really good serve.
Yes, he was on his heels. The ball might have gone out, but he chose to hand pass it. And usually those don't make it all the way up to the setter. Nice serve across this enormous gym.
That does not get
handled by the Dons. And then, again, it comes down to great serve. Bringing the libero way up to that 10-foot line. There you go, and you can tell that's wide from here.
Well, I think that what you're seeing too is both teams are trying to go to the middle. They're trying to establish the middle early on and get them involved to hopefully open up their outside attack a little bit more later in the match.
Mendoza back to serve for the Dons. Out to Tuileta, who hammers it out. No touch.
No, you know, he looked like he thought he had a... you know, an avenue down the line. He just tried to do a little too much with it instead of maybe looking to attack the high seam there.
Mendoza back. Faye in the middle, up to Tuileta again. Of course, they're not afraid to go to him twice.
No, and I think that, you know, both he and Capone Faye, you know, they're having success hitting that high seam into the deep corner already. You know, they try the high line, trying to get the touch, but it just hasn't worked. And so it's, you know, let's go with what has worked, the high seam.
Ma'a going for that short serve. It would have been nice if he could have pulled it off, but again, into the net.
Yeah, you know, that's not a good play there because that's been, over the last couple weeks, a real high-scoring rotation for Punahou with Micah serving. So,
number seven, Ryan Worley back. Faye handles it once again nicely. Poor set by Ma'a, but Tuileta has to go free ball over. Faye puts it up to Ma'a at the 12-foot line, up to Tuileta, who's able to put a little pepper on it even from back there.
Yeah, there's that high, you know, into the deep corner. Just give yourself a chance to fight another day. And, you know, Santa Barbara unfortunately wasn't able to come up with the dig.
Kick themselves on the replay for that. Tuileta jump serve, handled nicely in the middle. Nice dump spike with the left hand by Hart Pitcher.
You know, I like
you
this
kid. You have to
kid.
Establish that also early in the game, don't you?
You know, you do. I think
keep
that
the other
you,
team
have to, you have to create some indecisiveness or
right.
you know, uncertainty in the defense's perspective.
Faye to Ma'a. Ooh, in the middle to Tuileta at the 10-foot line.
You know, I like that play. I like using the back row attack on a first ball, good pass, as your first choice. You know, and you saw there the tempo was real quick.
And they only have Faye as an option.
Yeah.
And when you can establish Tuileta at the 10-foot line, that's going to put the defense on their heels for sure. Another out serve for the Buff and Blue.
Well, you know, it seems like, you know, both teams yesterday are kind of coming off of, you know, emotional matches. And they're kind of... not sleepwalking, but it doesn't seem like there's that same kind of emotion that's out here. And they're kind of, you know, we're getting here into the exciting part of the game. We'll see what
Griffin
happens.
Griffin Janney can wake this up. Tuileta, good. Out to Capone Faye in the middle there. Handled. Free ball hit. Ooh, put some pepper on it. Nice by Worley. Daniel Andrews takes the one set and just pinks it over in front.
You know, I love that play.
Yeah.
I love going to the middle in transition, especially after the other team has gone up and attacked the ball, and he had a great dig by Tuileta in the back. And
what else is he going to do
right
with that? So it's an unspikable ball, so it's very smart of him to know to just pull up. Ooh, backspin Sally off the pass there. Back to number four. Good hit by number four, Joe Rafferty.
Ooh,
by the Dons.
What a great play by Santa Barbara. They got tough serve, mishandled the set. They got to go high outside, and they, you know, this guy's just going to bang for the court, and he ends up getting a kill out of it. What a great play by Santa Barbara.
Hart pitcher back to serve for the Dons. He's going to do his jump spinny. In the middle to Andrews, long and lean, putting it down.
Yeah, and you notice there, Chris, that good pass like that, the Santa Barbara outside blockers are not, they're not getting involved. It's one-on-one, and you know, at 17-15 in the first game, I like being able to go to that option this late in the game.
And right now the Dons are wishing they had two more blockers, no doubt, at the net. If Punahou would get a serve in, I think game would go a lot more swimmingly for them, but let's see what the Dons are able to do with their serve. Puno has established a strong offense, just not a strong serving game yet. Tuileta to the outside gives the setter a lot of options. Back to Tuileta, who takes a little off.
Ooh, a little off speed there. I like that. I like attacking the high seam, and I think he wants it a little quicker though. That pace, he'd like it, the speed to come up.
Poor hand pass by the libero of the Dons. Got to get that up to the setter. There's just no excuse. If you get your hands on it, got to have that wrist strength or take the sweat off your hands to be able to pull that up to the setter. And timeout, Dons. They're going to see if they can pull things back together now that Punahou gets their serves back in.
Well, yeah, and I think that if I'm Santa Barbara in this timeout, I'm saying, hey, look, get us a sight out here. I mean, get us a pass. I think that, Hart, look at him possibly going to number seven, the opposite, Ryan Worley. Probably in some sort of a combination here, bringing the Will Pulice, around, seeing him possibly hit like a 31 that's way far away to create some space, and then set the thing in some capacity to Ryan Worley and see what they can do.
Well, but there's no doubt that the best offense for the Dons right now is the Punahou serving line.
Yeah.
I mean, I can't even actually recall what they've established. We know Punahou's established a great offense, and they're going to have to step up some offensive play here, because I'm sure Rick Toon is going to make sure his players get the serves in. Set back set to Worley, takes a good swing at it, brings it up to the net, a little bit tight. Yeah, a little bit too tight for the setter there.
Yeah, you're seeing some what I would call ball control stuff. Things that keep the ball in play type things are just not happening.
Number six, Carl Mendoza back to serve for the Dons. Perros, good pass, giving the setter lots of options to Ma'a, who takes a good swing at it.
Yeah, Scotty Perros is definitely the difference right now. His passing is real crisp and to the spot, and it's actually kind of low and got a little bit of pace to it, and forcing the offense to happen a lot quicker.
Ma'a back to serve for the Buff and Blue. Serves it out.
That's
there we
two
go.
In a row for him. At that high, that's their best scoring rotation, and that's two in a row that...
There's something about that Dawn formation that is maybe tempting them to get a little ambitious with their serves or something, but let's see Tuileta back at the line to serve. He's going to do his jump, put a little pepper on it, no doubt. Let's see what he does. Tuileta with the serve. Nice little floater to the middle. Handled well. Set. Free ball, Punahou. Tuileta in the middle. Handled up. Bonofé.
Great play. That back row set was just a little bit too low for Tuileta, so he took something off it and put it in a spot that he felt would give him an advantage. And sure enough, mishandled ball by Santa Barbara, and Capone Fay receives, gets a kill out of it. So great play by Tui on that.
Good time for a timeout for the Dons. 22-18. They've got to put some pepper in the pot right here to get it back.
Yeah, and you know what, too? It's the kind of thing where it's like, okay, They got to pass the ball coming out of this timeout. After the last timeout, they didn't really come out and pass the ball real well, and they're not really, they're, they need to be moving their feet and talking a little bit more. They seem a little quiet. You know, their trip is at the end. They kind of got to fire it up here and move the feet and get a pass so that they can run their offense. Because when they do that, they're hitting the ball in the court and they're getting some kills out of it. It's a good deal. So.
All right, teams approaching the courts once again.
You know, pitcher hasn't gone to the middle in this rotation too much, so I'd be interested to see if on a good pass that he gives it a
well. That's
know,
the key. A
tries
good pass.
Sneak one in.
There it is. Overset, and right now the Dons are not passing.
No,
making
no.
it very difficult for their setter to really do anything. He's either too tight or way too far out towards the 10-foot line to really get anything going. Let's see. Short pass, perfect pass by the Dons. One in the middle. There you go.
There you go. Great play by them. You know, great.
That's Santa Barbara volleyball right there.
Well, Joe Rafferty, you know, he cleared everybody out and got in there and made a great pass. And, you know, Channing Peak.
Well, and establishing that dump.
Yep.
They
yep.
had two blockers yep. going up for the dump instead of the one block there. In the middle. Excellent one.
Great play. Great play by Micah. That ball's going over. You know, there's where a big, you know, tall setter really right. helps the situation. So.
Number 11, Hayashida back to serve. Another set that just doesn't give the setter the options he needs. Had to bump set that.
And kind of an unfortunate play. I mean, that situation, it's not a real strong offensive rotation for Santa Barbara. And they get a bad pass, and the set location's not real good, and he tried to do the best he could with it. So, you know, first game to Punahou. So.
No doubt Chad Arneson and Rick Toon are going to ask their teams to wake up in this second game with some improved passing and some improved setting.
Or definitely so.
Serving. Yeah.
Definitely so. I think, you know, Punahou's be at, you know, and here's the trade-off. You know, is it you could make the case that, you know, Santa Barbara wasn't passing real well, and Punahou was serving well, and they maybe were trying to, you know, push the issue just a little bit too much,
right.
and were serving out. And so once they backed off a little bit, kept the ball in the court, their location of serving was pretty good, and it kept us Santa Barbara kind of off kilter in their offense. So,
well, let's do what the kids do nowadays and keep it real. I came here twice as an athlete myself from the mainland, and Santa Barbara Dons have a lot of things on their mind, like snorkeling and surfing, and the Punahou players have prom on their mind. So
yeah.
Volleyball may be secondary on these young boys' minds right now, and
yeah.
that would be perfectly understandable, except that they have fiery coaches who don't give a darn what's going on later tonight.
Yes.
And I guarantee you Rick Toon right now is going to give his team a pep talk or an earful.
Well, and I couldn't agree more.
Right.
You know, I mean, they might be, you know, thinking about limos and lays and girlfriends, and I doubt they're considering, you know, how they're going to put their hair up or anything like that, you know, or maybe they got to pick their tux up or whatever. But, you know, you can see Rick talking to kind of his three go-to guys there, and Micah and Capono and Tui, and he's, hey, you know, he might be telling them, hey, you know, we need to step it up
right.
a little bit. You know, this is, you know, we got what we wanted on the scoreboard, but it was less than what
right.
we want. Let's finish the week off good. They've had a great week here, and you want to finish it off well.
Right.
You know, last night they won game one. They, you know, kind of Miracosta came out and took it to them in game two. So you want to kind of, it's a challenge to, you know, see, hey, you know what? Game two, let's see what we can do here. Let's come out and...
And you and I have both played sports with Rick Toon for a number of years. We know Rick Toon, as a player and a coach, has one speed, full throttle. He's
yeah,
not
there,
about to let
no
these guys cruise
gear.
To a victory. Yeah.
There's no second, third. It, everything is in overdrive.
That's right. We play faculty Thursday night basketball, and Rick Toon is not afraid to throw an elbow or dunk on a fool. As we say on the basketball court, he has one speed, and he's going to demand that of his Punahou buff and blue. And Chad Arneson, too, he's got a reputation to protect.
Yeah, you know, he's a fiery guy.
Yeah.
And, you know, the teams that he's brought over here over the years have demonstrated a real high level of ball control. You know, he graduated 11 seniors last year. You know, so it's a, I don't want to say it's a down year because I think he's got a really nice team. He's got some nice pieces. They're 2-0 in their league right now.
Well, and a down year for Santa Barbara means only four kids go on to play D1 volleyball instead of the usual six, right?
Right, right. So,
game two here at Punahou School on Oahu Island here in Hawaii. Ma'a back to serve.
That's,
all right, here we go.
That's three in a row for him.
Three in a row for Ma'a into the net. The Dons providing some sort of raucous cheer as he was serving. I don't see that every day. Number six, Carl Mendoza back to serve for the Dons. Serving it short to Fay, puts him on his rear. Out to the hitter. Ma'a chooses to bring it back up. Free ball to Ileta, to the libero, to the middle. Nice up by Ma'a. Good going into the stands. Now we got some real volleyball going.
Much different play by Santa Barbara. You saw there on that transition play, they got a great pass. Their libero, you know, hustled his feet, got a great pass. They ran the back one and ended up getting a point out. So a great play by them.
Mendoza back to serve. Fay stepping in front of the libero. Tuileta puts a little bit of pepper on it. Out to the libero, outside. Good pass by Fay in the middle of the Ma'a, giving him lots of options. Out to Worley. Hit up by Thompson to Fay. Great dig by the libero, number Mendoza there. Free ball, libero. Perfect pass. Lots of good passing and setting here. Point,
oh,
Buff and
rally.
Blue. Good rally.
Well, and you know what, too? That was one of the things that Rick said to me before the match. He said, you know, I said, well, key, give me a key. He said, keep the rallies going.
Right.
You know, he felt that that was an advantage for them the longer the rallies went.
Tuileta back to serve. Nice little floater. Handled well. Oof. Buff
nice
and blue
play.
Into the net. That's a real hard set right there. Real line drive. What do we call that set?
They call that the 31, and you know, it's a really great play. If you can establish that, it's
hard to block.
Yeah, and it sets up all kinds of problems for the defense.
Right. Ma'a out to Tuileta, who makes a real wise choice.
Yeah, he does. And you know what? I don't know if that's a timing thing right now. It's a timing type of a set, but he seems like he's forcing Tui to have to do something instead of throwing it up a little higher and let Tui decide what he wants to do with that.
Tight set blocked.
Great play by Pono Fe. Yeah. Great play. You know, mention here, we got Pono's got a different lineup here in that they've inserted Trent Thompson in the opposite instead of Taylor Weens this game.
Another pass for the Dons. Now, one thing the Dons aren't used to is passing because the Punahou serving's been so poor.
Right.
But their passing wakes up now and gives the setter a couple of options for a kill for the Dons.
Well, they've already had three attempts in the middle, which were, you know, I mean, we're 7 points into this game, and they've already, you know, set to Channing Peak three times, and he's 2 for 3. So,
number 16, Josh Cass back to serve for the Dons. Tui led a hand pass to Ma'a in the middle to Andrews, handled well. Nice set. Dump attempt by the Dons. Tui led at the 10-foot line.
Yeah, now
Worley,
you see that?
No chance.
Yeah, now that was, he gave him just a little bit more height on that. The location was the same, it was good, but Tui had just a little bit more run at it and he could get off the ground. So you could tell he was more comfortable at unloading.
Those of you on the mainland, that's Tuileta, who a lot of people are saying is one of the best volleyball players in the country right now.
For his age, he is, yes.
Nice pass, giving pitcher some options there to swing. Number 12, Channing Peak, cannot get a handle on it. Little miscommunication.
No, it was a misplay. I think the location out of, from the setter pitcher was a little bit
Paris back to serve. Pitcher in the middle. Hits it up off the shoulder. Ball stays live to Ma'a. Going back to,
what a play. What a play. You know, this Channing Peak has had a really good run here. He's kept the game, you know, even here. But great play by Santa Barbara. He gets stuffed, covers it on off his shoulder, goes back over to Punahou. You know, that's kind of one of those that you question as to, is that a momentum changer or what? So we'll see here.
Will Howard, number 32, back for the Dons. No relation to Phillies slugger Ryan Howard.
No, he's not quite built the same way, I don't think.
No.
Ryan's a little bigger.
Kapono Fay back to serve. You know, in this volleyball world, small world, a lot of same last names. If you're a volleyball players raise volleyball players. We know that from experience, especially here at Punahou. But
well, you saw there.
Gone.
Well, it was a great dump. And the libero, when he went to play that, he had an open hand. I thought the minute he played, I thought it was a lift. So I was surprised that it was a little bit late on the call.
Hart pitcher handled well by Tuileta, giving his setter lots of options to set Ma'a, who's dug handily. I got it. You take it.
Yeah, you know, that's got to be Joe Rafferty's play. Right. You know, he's the outside hitter.
Well, you don't want anyone coming back to the 10-foot line.
No, especially not the middle guy.
Right. If you're behind it, you take it. Even if the libero can get to it, if he has to come back for it. Number five for Punahou, Quinlan Doherty, back to serve. Let's see what he can do it with it. Nice left-handed floater. Bad pass by the Dons. Out to Worley, who takes a good swing, and they've got to tighten that block.
Well, you notice he's hitting the line again.
Right.
Remember early in the first game, they had a lot of success going down the line. They got away from it because they weren't passing the ball real well.
Mm-hmm.
You know, even though that pass was not real well, the set location was good. It gave him an opportunity to bang that line against Punahou. So.
Number four, Joe Rafferty back to serve for the Dons. Ma'a takes a cross-court swing at it.
Yeah, I like that play. Noah Hayashida, you know, came quick, and he brought Tui in on a combination. They kept Micah off here, and it really kind of forced the Santa Barbara block to have to, you know, be kind of off foot. They were mm-hmm. they were out of place, so to speak.
Nice pass, giving them options. Nice one-handed one, jump set up to Tuileta, who puts a little bit on it. Well, good pass by the libero there. Good block. Pitcher digs it up. Up again, taking another swing on it. Doug handily, and we got a net call. Dons, but it was a good offensive play by Punahou.
It was a good play. Nice play. You know, one of the differences that I'm seeing is that Punahou's digging the ball in a position where Micah can, he's got three options.
Does he get a kill in the books for that? Because it was a net call.
You know, I'm not sure.
All right. Well, we're gonna have someone look that up for us. Maybe freshman Meredith Colat for Punavision will go online and look that up for us.
You see here, you got Micah. This is a rotation where it's a great scoring rotation for them, putting the ball in the court.
And taking a big swing block by Tuileta.
Okay.
Blocking so, Ryan Worley there.
So. You know, here you are. Michael is 0 for 3 in his last three serves. Now he's put two balls in, and they've made two points.
It makes
points.
A difference.
Oh,
in the game of volleyball, it makes a big difference when you put
huge
the ball in.
Huge difference.
Well, here we go. And
yeah.
It's back into the net for Michael Ma'a.
And sometimes it's not right. necessarily the toughness of the serve as it is the matchup of the front rows,
right.
the blockers and the hitters, you know, against Santa Barbara. For whatever reason, it seems to work in that rotation.
Number six, Mendoza back to serve for the Dons. Puts it down. That's nice. That's Noah Hayashida in the middle for Punahou. Just, it's a case of Ma'a having a dozen options.
Yes.
There.
Yes. And when he's jumping and taking it at a high position,
right.
high part point like that, the defense really has to guess almost.
Right. Tuileta back to serve. Jump serve. Going to take a little off it. Puts it just a little too tight for pitcher to do anything with it.
Great play.
Great play by Tuileta. They're going to go free ball to Fay, who tries to put a little pepper on it. I'm sure Rick Toon wishes. Just listen.
Yeah,
give it to the Dons. The Dons' offense is not clicking.
No.
We don't need you leaning backwards and trying for a kill here. Now we got Ryan Worley back to serve for the Dons. To Fay. To Ma'a, to Tuileta, the 10-foot line. Doug bringing pitcher way out. Worley takes a good swing. Tuileta handles it nicely. Ma'a puts up a good set. Great block, great pass.
Great cover by Trent Thompson there.
And pitcher brings it out. Once again, handcuffing their setter into not too many options. Tuileta puts it down. Worley with a great dig. I got it, you take it. Again, pitcher showing some frustration there, and he's just saying, look, guys, I can't do anything with these passes.
Well, yeah, and I mean, you know, that ball gets dug all the way to the left side of the court, and, you know, pitcher's got a long ways to go for that. The libero's standing right there. He's got it. That's where he's got to take charge and just say, look, I got this. And
Hayashida back to serve. Going to take a little off it. Backspin, hand pass. You know, we'll talk about this at a break. Pet peeve of mine. Blocked well by the Dons. You know, Peter, I cannot believe I'm sitting here as a volleyball player myself watching back row players take hand passes that spin 14 times before they get to the setter. I wish they'd eliminate that rule and bring back the skillful bump pass that you and I grew up with, but that's political. Let's not get political right now. Let's enjoy some volleyball. Good. Blocked by Andrews, out of bounds for the Dons, and now the Dons are getting some offense.
As you speak about your pet peeve, it's coming to pass. The international FIVB is ruling
out the Puna Vision. They listen to Puna Vision, and you and me complain about it every year. Nice block by the Dons.
Great pass.
Good hit. We got some good volleyball here. Andrews going up
with the set. What a set by Danny Andrews.
Andrews, who's laughing himself. He doesn't pull off that set too often.
No.
The bench is off their feet.
Well, yeah, so it's a rule change. All the rules filter down from the international scene. In the international scene, they're taking the hand pass away. Everybody's got to hit the. Ooh, everybody's got to use the forearm. Great serve by.
Great serve. Back, right,
Dylan
corner.
Gerard.
I mean, it's really poor judgment on the Don's part. You can put your foot on the line and tell whether it's going to go in or out. But it is a great serve position.
Well, you know,
if you could serve there 25 times.
It's the one mistake that Joe Rafferty's made passing-wise in this game. He's really come out and moved his feet well, gotten himself behind the ball, centered on the ball. You know, we say midline. And really kind of anchored their passing and kind of put them back in this game, so to speak. They're only down by four, but partly because Puno's been serving the ball in the court a little bit more, hadn't been giving them those cheap passes. So, you know, Puno's been, they've kind of created a little separation here.
Right.
Once, Hart Pitcher went to the front row.
Right.
When he's in the front row, he's only got two attackers, and so it makes it, they're not quite as strong as they are when Ryan Worley, the opposite, is in the front. And they've got three attackers. So
and it's cliche. We would say this about six-year-olds playing volleyball, but if you can get that pass up to the setter and give him options, every team's going to play well. And that when we see Santa Barbara give Pitcher the option of a good set, bringing him way out again, giving him one option for a set, Tuileta with a dig. Up to Ma'a, who does a wonderful dink over the block.
Great play by Punahou. You know, they knew that here they are, they're serving Joe Rafferty, and then he's not passing well. They know they got to set him. They got three guys blocking. I mean, it's just.
Once again, another pass by the Dons. They're going to watch this game and be embarrassed by their passing, and I'm sure Chad Arnson, the coach, will show them this replay to show them what bad passing does to setters.
Great play there. You know, yeah, I mean, here they get the ball back. Their libero steps up, Mendoza, makes a great pass, and then they start running this combination. They bring Joe Rafferty in on like what they call an X1, and it just creates all these different options, and they end up getting a side out of it.
Right.
So,
number 32, Will Howard back to serve for the Dons.
Ryan's little brother, is that, did we determine
that? No, we established not related to Philadelphia Phillies slugger. But interesting, let's take this timeout. Let's play a little game. I like to. Oh, we don't have a timeout. We'll play the game at the next timeout. We got Capone Fay back to serve for the Buff and Blue. Now, he's served pretty well tonight so far. Let's see how he does here. Nice flat serve to one of the outside hitters, putting him out of commission there. Capone Fay with the dig. You know, Fay passes really well, doesn't he?
He does.
Not afraid to stand in the middle and take serves and take digs.
Well, and you find that he gets his feet set. You know, he's got a nice wide base when he's passing, and so, you know, there's a lot of stability there.
Hand pass to Pitcher, who once again with a miscommunication to Pelluce.
Well, that's a misplay on the setter. You know, I thought the hitter was in a good spot. He just missed him. You know, the location was just not there. So, and that happens.
Fay back to serve again, 19-12. Punahou lead. And again, just not clicking for Pitcher in the middle there. Puts up a good block up to Andrews. Oh, gonna take it. Fay in the middle, gonna put a little bit on it. Free ball to Pitcher in the middle. tries to bring it down. Pitcher's frustrated, and he should be.
Yeah, you know that his middle, Will Pulucci, he's too tight to the net. He needs to be off the net a little bit more so he gets a full swing at it. It's real difficult for the setter to see that because he's gone by him, and he's actually having to set it over his shoulder. It makes it real challenging.
Fay back to serve for the Buff and Blue, the pitcher in the middle. Let's see if they could get something going. Blocked on the outside, X play. Takes a good swing. Worley takes a good swing out for the Buff and Blue. It's a dance, isn't it? It's a dance. To make another prom reference, but setters and outside hitters, or especially middle hitters, it's a dance. You have to know your partner. You have to know where he's going to be.
And you know what? This is probably the most challenging spot in running a 5-1, which is one setter. And Santa Barbara runs that. When you don't pass and you're the setter and you're up front and your hitters aren't putting the ball away, it's somewhat frustrating. And you're seeing that in Hart pitcher's, his body language, his facial expressions. I mean, he's struggling. Right. And you know, his hitters aren't helping him. They're not getting him the pass. And then when he's getting them a good set, they're not putting the ball away. You know, and credit to Punahou. They're defending well. They're serving well.
You can see the last year's national championship, MiraCosta Mustangs walking into the gym for the next game. I remind you, on Puna Vision at 5 o'clock this afternoon, we'll be broadcasting again live.
Do you suppose those are their uniform shorts? I might have to go get my sunglasses.
I hope those are not their uniform shorts, but we'll see. We'll give them a hard time if it is, those bright green board shorts. But you never know with kids today. That's clearly out. Good timeout by the Dons.
You know, that's one of those cardinal sins, especially when you got these guys
coming
so
off a timeout.
Oh, it's timeout. But also, I mean, Santa Barbara is down. I mean, they're ready to head to the airport,
right,
you know, and catch the plane home.
Pitcher back to serve for the Dons, down 21-13. Going to be a hard comeback. Off the net.
Ooh.
Now, that's a rule that has not been in existence a long time, but I enjoy it. It's exciting. What do you think?
I don't like it. I'm not a fan of the let serve. You know,
it adds an element of chaos to the game that I like. Back to good set to Kamatule in the middle. We'll take a good look and talk about him in the middle. Kamatule, a three-sport athlete for Punahou. Probably four-sport, actually.
He might be. You never know. I mean, you know, all the coaches on campus look at his body frame at 6'8" and 280,
right,
and, you know, want to get their hands on him.
That's right. He moves buildings here on campus, too, during the summer, I believe. When we need a building moved a few feet to the left or right, we employ him. So Don's back to serve on a little roll here, see if they can score some consecutive points, get back in the game. Pitcher back to serve. Ooh, nice little jump serve. Tuileta handles it nicely.
Well, you know, he had three good serves that were forced Punahou to either mishandle it or be aced, and you know, weren't able to get an effective set location-wise. And once they did, you know, Tui kind of mismatched the block.
Coming out of the game for the Buff and Blue. Nice hand pass there. And
ooh,
pitcher
swinging a miss.
Yeah, miscommunication between him and his outside hitter, number four, Joe Rafferty there, but they laugh it off. They'll get it back together, no doubt. Back to the middle there. Worley to the outside, blocked. Hayashida, Ma'a, looks like Ma'a's taking credit for the block there.
Oh, you know, they seem to have Santa Barbara's number here.
Yeah.
You know, everything they're throwing at them, they're coming up with.
Worley in the middle, some sort of.
We got a foot fault by Scotty Parros. I think he was 2 feet inside the court there when he served that thing.
Number four, Jill Rafferty back to serve for the Dons. Nice little floater taking Hayashida in the middle there, who's going to take it himself.
I like that play.
That's a great play.
Yeah.
Unexpected, because when the hitter has to serve it, that's difficult to come up to the net and spike it after that.
Very much so.
Passed it.
Well, what you saw was the pass was off the net,
yeah,
and Hayashida stayed off the net and open. Conversely, that similar type situation occurred with Santa Barbara, and they struggled with it. You saw what happened when the hitter stays open off the net a little bit, they're able to get a swing and a nice attack for a kill. So
yeah. Well, while we got a couple minutes here to talk between matches, I like to play a game called Stump the Chump. And you want to guess who the chump is in this scenario? Let me ask you a question,
gosh.
Peter.
What is older? Am I the chump?
You are. Well, we'll see. We'll see. Okay. What is older, the sport of volleyball or Punahou School?
I'm going to say Punahou School.
You're not a chump. Punahou School established in 1841, and the sport of volleyball established in the year 1875.
Whew,
invented, okay. I believe, by Chris McLaughlin in 1875. But Punahou School, we'll give you a little tour of you for those of you on the mainland who may not be familiar with Punahou. We have some famous volleyball alumni. We've got one alumni in the White House right now. Barack Obama graduated from Punahou. But let's talk about the Punahou alumni in the volleyball world.
Well, do you want to go male or female?
Well, that's your choice.
Because, you know, the most, I guess, decorated or accomplished female would have to be Lindsay Berg, who is a starting setter for the U.S. Women's National Team. Currently, I believe she's playing professionally in Turkey. So.
And on the men's side, there's a wide variety from Hugh
Foster. You have two Olympians. You've got Stein Metzger,
right,
and Kevin Wong both played on the beach in the Olympics. I believe Stein was in Sydney. And
Kevin Wong, don't forget, we're obligate contracted to mention one of People Magazine's 50 most beautiful people. He loves it when we mention that.
Really? Okay. I didn't realize that that was one of our sponsors. So
yes.
I'll be sure to remember that the next time around. So.
But long history here, and Santa Barbara has quite the volleyball history themselves.
Yes, they do. You have probably two of the best volleyball players of all time coming out of Santa Barbara, and Karj Kirai and John Hanley. So, you know, John Hanley's kind of that sleeper guy, you know? He has the good fortune or the misfortune of having played with Karj, you know?
Yes.
It's like, you play with Karj, and you know everybody looks to Karj, but here you get to play with the best guy in the world, and you know it makes you better. So
right. Does make you better. It is a long and big shadow to stand in, and if my little brother is listening, I'm sure him and Hanley have a lot to talk about. So standing in the shadow of someone of greatness, it is not easy sometimes. So we're back here on the court. For game three, Punahou is up 2-0 against the Santa Barbara Dons. Santa Barbara High School actually founded in the 1800s also, about 1865. And they have a rich history. And we've got Justin Cam in for the Punahou Buff and Blue. And those of you on the mainland, Peter, do you want to explain the mascot for the Buff and Blue?
There isn't a mascot,
right,
actually. The Buff and Blue actually refers to the sand and the
buff
ocean.
Buff color.
Yeah, the buff color is representative of the sand, and the blue is representative of the ocean.
And so many people refer to us as the Puns, right?
Yeah.
Short for Punahou.
And I don't think that has any relationship to, or you know, the wordage. You
right.
Know, the language, the English language.
Faye back to pass. Tuileta sending a message. And that message is, I'm going to prom.
Well, I think both teams are starting in the same rotations that they've been starting.
Right.
You know, for the first two games. And you saw a great pass by Kapono Fay, which you talked about in game two. And, you know, he's able
Ma'a
to.
Zipping it. Ma'a is really experimenting with the serves unsuccessfully tonight.
Well,
Close
I think
up
we know
aggressive.
What he's working on in practice next week.
Right.
You know?
Well, probably tonight, knowing Rick Toon.
No, he's going to the prom.
No, not if Rick Toon has anything to say about it. He's going to have him on the back line of the dance floor. Here we go, Ma'a. We should mention free ball to pitcher. Faye handles it, bringing it up to Ma'a with some options. And out ball by Tuileta.
Oh, I thought there was a touch, too. You know, you're seeing kind of a different transition here. You know, is it
right.
Punahou's getting swings, Santa Barbara's not getting too many swings in transition, and you know, we're fortunate enough to have Tui hit that ball out.
Joe Rafferty back to serve for the Santa Barbara Dons. Nice, great serve on the back line. Great pass up to the middle.
Ooh, I don't know. You know, I thought that was a violation on Tui. I don't think that ball landed before. You know, you had a situation here where ball hit the tape and it was slow to get to the ground.
Right.
And Tui's momentum,
took
you know,
under.
Took him under. And he went under before the ball actually hit the ground, even though it was a kill. So you get a point to Santa Barbara.
Here we go. Rafferty back to serve. Let's see if he puts it. Fay stepping in front of the libero. We'll talk about that in a moment. Great effort by the libero.
Hit. Oh, they got
They're
away with that.
Not
oh, he
let
called
it go.
It. Called it.
And let's bring that back to Capone Fay stepping in front of the libero once again. Not afraid to pass the ball.
Well, I like his aggressiveness.
That's right. Last thing you want is someone deflating from the ball, retreating from the ball. We also want that libero to get as many touches
as
possible.
That's a back row attack.
Here we go.
Yeah,
maybe Fay will be the tallest libero in college volleyball next year.
You know, a lot of teams are doing that. They're taking outside hitters that were outside hitters in high school and making them into liberos in the college ranks.
Someone I went to school with, Eric Sullivan, was a fantastic libero, and he was not by any means short. Good block by the Dons.
I believe he was a first-team All-American. He was 6'4". I mean, they're bigger and stronger. They can cover more court.
If they
can pass, it's a great advantage.
Great pass to the middle, giving the setter lots of options. Number 8, Justin Cam hitting into the net for the Buffalo Blue.
He's given a shot here. I haven't seen him play this year yet, and I think it's he's given an opportunity to play and see what he can do. And so,
and Capone Fay wisely lets it go out.
Boy, you know, you talked early in game one about putting your left foot on the line there. You know, he knew right where that line was and got out of the way.
That's
and played a little
textbook.
Dodgeball.
Put that in slow motion and show young players how to do that. Great pass by the Rafferty in the middle. And we've got a touch.
Definite touch.
Definite touch. Let's see if it gets called. It is called. We got number 10 coming in for Santa Barbara. We haven't seen him yet. Jonah Iwanaga for the Dons. We have not seen this young man yet play tonight. Let's see. He's coming off the bench. Back to serve, Iwanaga for the Dons. Good jump serve, putting Tuileta down. Great.
Oh, what a
dig
play
by the libero. Free ball to Rafferty. Tuileta. Ma'a to the outside.
Fay what a great play. Hey, how about this kid Iwanaga coming in here? He sat for 2 games. I didn't see him play last night at all. And he comes in and just rips this jump serve and puts all kinds of problems in Pono's lap.
Here we go, Iwanaga back to serve again. Rips another one into the net. Here we go.
Just as I was giving him the praises. What's up with that? Huh?
Rick Toon greeting Justin Cam coming onto the bench.
You know,
into the game, Dylan Girard.
Yeah, and I guess Rick is he's pretty committed to staying with his 6'2".
Right. We'll see. He may be pulling his starters out in a little while, but not yet. Iwanaga takes a good swing. This young man is not afraid to come into the game and swing. That's what you got to do, right?
Well, you know, I like that.
He's fighting for a spot.
At this point, they got nothing to lose. He's got an opportunity to play. You know,
let's
swing at the court.
For those young volleyball players out there, let's give them some advice. If you are riding the pine, as we say, if you're a bench player, have you ever gone a season where every player doesn't get a chance? You always get a chance to prove yourself on the court.
Oh, yeah.
And it's being ready for that chance. Great pass to pitcher. Into the middle, blocked. Pitcher up again. Worley to swing. Let's see if it hits the line. It does
play.
Hit the line. Once again, they get the ball in pitcher's hands.
Yep.
In a decent position, and the offense comes alive.
Well, and there's a little bit of jawing at the net going on here, you know. Channing Peak and Daniel Andrews are kind of going at it a little bit here.
Well, and I would love to play against a team when it was prom night. I could just think of the rags I would create. I would make the other team cry, no doubt, with some creative trash talk. But Capone Fay coming back to the line here for the Punahou Buff and Blue. We've got an 8-8 tie. We've got a good game here. Nice little serve to the libero. 12 rotations on that pass, on that hand pass, but that's legal nowadays. Oh, great! Attempted dump by the setter. Ma'a up, tries to grab some line, misses.
Oh, he got away with that. I did not like that choice out of him to dump it. His hitters have been hitting well this game, you know. You know, sometimes the setters, they just they want to get in on the action, right, so to speak. You know, and it's like, hey, you know what? Your job is to set your boys.
Well,
and
establish the dump.
Yeah. Well, but
establish,
let's not overdo it.
Not overdo it, right? Yes. Great pass in the middle, giving the setter lots of options. Good dig off the net, bringing pitcher way out for Worley, who hits it out.
Well, you know, the secret of that dump is, you know, there's the skill of it, and then there's the timing of it. You know, you might classify it as the tactics of it. You know, when is a good time?
Well, you got to be able to bring that ball down. If it's not going to go down, if it's just going to go straight across, it's probably not a good, you're not in a good position to
dunk. No. So you see here, bad pass, and, you know, Joe Rafferty having a hard time, ends up hitting the antenna, so it's a violation.
Great serve. Dawn offense, pitcher, giving him some options. Once again, was that third hit or was that a little bit of confusion on the Dons there? Pitcher may have thought it was a third hit because he took a good swing at it and it pays off for him.
I think he's trying to prove us wrong.
Yes.
Somebody's telling him, hey, just go and swing at it.
You know, and there's nothing wrong with someone trying to take charge of the game either. But pitcher back to serve. He's going to try and do it all on his own right now.
This is a good rotation for them.
Let's see what they can get going. Interesting, made a big sound. Went slow. Tuileta taking a big swing on the ball. They call it out.
Oh, I thought that thing
was
good.
Looking for a point. Rick Toon looks confused by the call also.
Well, I thought that was a great serve by pitcher. Kind of put Puno on the ropes to begin with. So
right.
We'll see what he does here.
Pitcher back to serve for the Dons. Fay bringing his setter way out. Tuileta takes a nice free ball hit, puts some pepper on it. Pitcher in the middle does not connect with the middle, but able to put it down. Tuileta, a little bit too much to handle for a single block there.
You know, Tui's real good at just challenging the block. You know, he didn't do a very good job of getting off the net there and getting a, you know, big approach, and so he just swung at the high hands knowing that you know, it would rattle a little bit, and he ended up being successful.
Don pass to the middle. Ma'a with the one up pancake. Did not get it up for the Puns.
Great set by Pritcher on that. You know, the pass was not quite, you know, complete there, but he decided to go to it and force the issue in the middle. Anyways, I like that. You know, you're looking at Santa Barbara's team, you know, Coach Chad here, he's giving his kids a chance to play. You know?
Connor Doherty into the game for the Puns. Junior outside hitter. Tuileta, heavy ball.
Play.
Brought back by the libero. Tuileta again. Good free ball out to the back of the court. Worley forced to the left hand. Ma'a in the middle to Kupono Fay, who goes beach volleyball style. Back left corner. Reminiscent of Punahou alumni Billy Berger. Sure he's out there listening. He invented that shot, no doubt. Tuileta back to serve. That's a great play by Fay.
Oh, man.
Impressive.
It was very impressive.
Impressive for a boy his height, a young man his height, to be able to control a ball and put it in the back corner like that. Good volleyball skills, good everything there.
Great
Ma'a,
set.
Tuileta back. Going to put a free ball up for the Dons. Libero calls it to middle to the pitcher in the middle. Worley, again, forced with the left, but does not stop the young man from putting the kill down.
No, great choice by Pritchard to get the ball out to him. You know, location was not quite that good, but Worley did his best to just get the ball to the floor, so great job.
Ma'a, there's the options we've been looking for to Hayashida in the middle. That's a great, once again, great volleyball for young players out there. All starts with a good pass.
Yep, and he's you know, he's doing a nice job of getting the ball out of his hands quickly to that quick hitter. So.
Kelsey Yogi, back to serve for the Buff and Blue. Coming up.
Oh, what a play by Kupono Fay there. You know, that time he waited a little bit longer. You know, the set was a little bit higher. His previous time around, he was too early and got used. This time, he waited and took a little extra time and got a nice stuff off.
Kelsey Yogi back to serve. Brother of Sydney Yogi, who is currently setting for the Texas Longhorns. One of your favorite former players, right?
What? Well, actually, she graduated. She was she finished her eligibility a year ago.
I knew that. I was testing you.
But yes, she played for the Longhorns.
Seems like yesterday she was here in this gym playing for us. Nice pass up to Tuileta in the middle, off the chest of Iwanaga. Great play. And the Dons, that's not going to wake them up. Nothing will.
Hey, this kid Iwanaga scored points. You know, he's been in for 3 points, and he scored two out of three. So
Chad Arneson on the bench celebrating with his team. Iwanaga back to serve. Excited. Ma'a. Number 12, Taylor Weens puts it down for the Buff and Blue, coming out of the game, getting replaced by Dylan Gerald. There's that Punahou offense again. Many weapons to choose from. We got Dylan Gerard back to serve for the Punahou Buff and Blue. Back tight, joust at the net.
Hey,
goes to the punts.
You know what I like about that was, you know, Coach Chad for Santa Barbara, in all of this, you know, intensity and whatnot, he still understands that, look, it's about having fun out here, you know, and he's going to give kids a chance to play, laughing and smiling with them.
Pitcher outside to Worley, one of his favorite targets. Worley does not get it past the block.
Well, you saw there that, you know, Micah got all the way out to the line this time, right. You know, and sealed it real well, and he tried to hit the thing off the line. It didn't work that time.
Worley past the pitcher into the middle.
Great play.
Yeah, and that's number 12, Cunning Channing Peak.
Boy, he hit that thing at a nice high spot, hit it deep into the corner. Great play by them. I liked it that he's still forcing the ball in the middle. Hey, and they're right in this game here. You know, they're only down by 1 point.
Down 1 point in beautiful Honolulu, Hawaii. If you've stumbled onto this webpage looking for something else, welcome to Puna Vision, where the Punahou Buff and Blue are currently leading the Santa Barbara Dons 18-16 in Kapono Fei back to set. Once again, this young man heading to University of Hawaii to play volleyball next year. Nice flat serve. Let's see. Oh, out of bounds.
Oh, gosh. You know, this is when Santa Barbara has their setter up in the front row,
right.
Punahou has scored, you know, bunches of points. That's where they've overmatched them. And the setter's in the front row now. And to serve the ball out, you're giving them a free rotation across the front that's not good.
Tight set to Tuileta, who once again.
Great hit. Great hit.
Get a touch off the block, but too much to handle. The Dons have not established a block against the Punahou offense yet. They're still waiting to do that. Peros back to serve. Great pass by Worley into the middle for the Buff and Blue. Out to Tuileta, who's going to hit that heavy ball to the libero. Handled. There's the dump. Big mistake.
Yeah.
Chad Arneson has his head in his hands.
Yeah, he doesn't like that. No. He and I talked about that before the game.
It's just a perfect set.
Well,
that deserves a hit.
Yeah, I mean he gets a great pass like that. You gotta give something to one of your hitters to let them finish the play.
Pitcher back to serve. Tuileta handles it. Up, gonna hit that heavy and high ball. That's what we like about him, right? He hits a heavy ball but also up high.
Yeah, and you know what? He's had a lot of success against this team, hitting that high seam to the deep corner. You know, so I think that, you know, as long as you keep doing that, you're going to have success.
Ma'a back to serve, having a hard night of serving. To the middle, the pitcher in the middle. Ma'a unable to handle it. There it is. And that's how it's done.
Great play by them. You know, and in that situation, Ma'a, he's got to be set and ready. And he's still moving on defense. And, you know, you're going to have a difficult time coming up with a dig in that situation.
Joe Rafferty back to serve. Kapono Fei handles it easily. Tuileta takes something off it. See, that's the balance. Tuileta goes hard, 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 soft.
Well, and he knew that he didn't have to swing real hard,
right.
Because you know, Micah gave him a nice set in that he went against the flow. The block had all
defense
kinds of holes
on the heels.
In it. The defense was on their heels, and right. So a great opportunity for a change.
Tuileta going to take something off. Worley back, put some pepper on it. Out to Fay into the net on the outside.
Oh, great effort. Great effort by Joe Rafferty on that one. You know, this rotation here tonight has been, or this afternoon, has been a real good one for Punahou with Tui in the back row, you know, serving. You know, Capono's had many swings here, mostly because Tui has, he's served tough. He's made a lot of digs, and the digs that he's made, they've been good passes so that Micah can run the middle, but he's also got now Capono Fay on the outside getting his share of kills too. So,
well, and besides the distraction of it being prom night, you probably don't want to play against a bunch of guys who want to get out of this gym so they can go get into those limos and tuxedos.
Well, you know, there's only a couple of them that are seniors, and Capono Fay is one of them. And so maybe he's, you know, encouraging the kid, his teammates, boys, yeah, we need to finish this thing up.
Right.
Okay.
Daddy's got a deposit on a limo.
I got the limo coming, baby. You know, we got to get the tux.
Those things aren't cheap, and they charge by the hour, as we all remember. And Rick Toon will be doing some refereeing tonight. He is a dean of students, and he'll most likely be doing some refereeing on that dance floor tonight at prom night.
Well, if we little had a camera, sides, we had a little Punavision there. We might be able
there
to insert him on the dance floor.
That's right. Here we go. Antenna ball. Once again, this is at least the third time Worley's faced, forced to hit it with his left hand, and we know that he's not left-handed. So he's got to give a little wink to pitcher and tell him to bring it inside a little. Pitcher comes way out again for another set, puts it on Worley's right hand, who's blocked, but out of bounds. Hayashida wanted it.
Yeah, he did a real nice job getting out there and sealing the seam, and you know, just had his hands turned out to the outside there.
Oh, interesting serve. Fantastic serve. Handled nicely.
Oh, what a play.
That was Fay again, right? Comes up to.
Great play by Capono Fay just to get his feet to that ball.
Right.
And then the location of that set by Micah Ma'a was really extraordinary.
Fay loves to swing on the ball, and if he's not careful, they're going to put him in a libero shirt next year. He's got to be real careful. Yogi back to serve. Good serve to the back corner. Worley, perfect set to Worley. Handled nicely by Tuileta.
Oh, nice set.
Nice. That's a St. John Smith bump set that worked out fine for the Buffalo.
It was very good. Very good.
Well, not the best volleyball we've seen in this gym, but an impressive show by the Punahou Buffalo Blues. And we're going to try and think of a player of the game here.
Well, I think that, you know, you saw two teams that were coming off of emotional matches last night, and both teams kind of rallied a little bit. I think Santa Barbara struggled a little bit with just trying to handle the ball. They struggled off a serve receive, didn't have quite the offensive versatility that maybe they had last night. With one of their guys going down with the sickness, he's got a strep throat, and so it reduced their options offensively and didn't allow them the opportunity to kind of be as competitive as they were last night. So,
and we're joined by our player of the game tonight, Capono Fay. How are you, Capono? All right, we want to congratulate you on a great game. And we want to know, we kept talking about, we're sure you'll watch this broadcast later, but we kept talking about your passing tonight. We liked your hitting, you liked the team in general, but we noticed your fearlessness in passing, not afraid to step in front of the libero. You passed that great serve down there at the end there. Do you want to talk about your passing as a big guy?
Yeah. Well, I thought I didn't do as well today with passing.
Okay.
Yeah, I didn't get it. Get to the center as much as yesterday, and I tried to get Scotty to like come over and take more ball, take more court at least,
yeah,
to make it easier for me, especially when I'm hitting outside.
All right.
Yeah.
Can you tell us a little bit about the game plan for today? I mean, you had this emotional match last night against MiraCosta, and you've got an afternoon game here, which is not usual. Can you tell us a little bit about what the game plan was going in against Santa Barbara?
The main thing was just kind of forget about yesterday, not let it get to our heads. And Santa Barbara is a great team, and we knew they were going to come out strong, especially after their loss yesterday. So we just wanted to come out with more intensity and trying to stay as focused.
Yeah, I noticed too that that both you and Tui, you didn't have quite the emotion that you had last night, but you both kind of you found some success hitting that high seam. Can you talk? Was that something you guys noticed in the scouting report or?
We noticed the middle would get a little coming a little late if we had a good pass. So just trying to hit the seam.
So that was a part of it. It was designed as part of it. Awesome.
All right, we're going to let you go, but we have one last question. Okay. Prom night. You going to prom?
Yes, sir.
All right, well, we don't want to waste any more of your time. We know you got to get your hair did, get that limo.
Yeah.
We want to congratulate you on a good game.
Thank you.
And have a happy prom.
Thank you. All right.
Well, that's it for us. I'm Chris Schwengel and my partner, Peter Balding. We're going to sign off for this evening, and we want to invite you to join us at 5 o'clock for the next Puna Vision webcast, where we'll see the Kamehameha Big Island Warriors
from Ke'au against the MiraCosta Mustangs.
Want to say good night and aloha.